and wealth portfolio manager, market strategist Michael Lee. Michael, it is good to see you this morning.
Thanks for having me.
How would you be positioning yourself ahead of what is a big week at the Federal Reserve, the jobs number out at the end of the week, and of course the earnings period?
Well, look, I think you got to have exposure to U.S. stocks. It's just a matter of how aggressive you want to be. What I'm looking to this earnings season is, are we going to punish all the losers the same, or are we going to reward the winners? Is there going to be a diversion between winners and losers, or is everything going to move in unison like we did with the last quarter earnings, where we had that pretty horrific sell-off at the end of the third quarter going into the end of the year?
Yeah, but I mean, you see a change in this market with the Federal Reserve on hold, correct? Friday we get an article in the Journal basically saying, look, they may not necessarily only be on hold for raising interest rates, they may actually even be on hold in terms of the balance sheet unwind. Is that a positive?
I think that would give you a short-term benefit, but in the long run, I think that would be horrific. I mean, your playbook for that is Japan. You had some great interviews last week, especially with Ray Dalio, talking about the little gunpowder that the Federal Reserve would have left if something bad were to happen. So if the Fed stops raising rates, if the Fed stops reducing their balance sheet, if we do have a downturn, I don't see any point in the near future, but if something does happen, some external factor slows down our economy, what is the Fed left? What do they have left? What are they going to do?
There's not a lot of wiggle room. That's the whole point, right?
Because
the Fed does not have wiggle room after having rates at 0% for so long.
Well, and to put it in perspective, the Fed funds is now where it was in 2008 when Bear Stearns went under. Okay. In addition to that, we have a $4 trillion balance sheet. So what can the Fed really do, right? What would be the net effect if we took the balance sheet from $4 trillion to $6 trillion and we took rates from
they're talking about taking the balance sheet from $3.5 trillion to maybe $2.5 trillion as opposed to, you know, $1.5 trillion or something. I mean, they're not talking about going up to $6 trillion.
Yeah, well,
they're talking about going down.
No, I'm speaking theoretically. Okay. I'm just saying if they were to stop reducing the balance sheet, you further reduce their power in the event of another downturn. So right. I think the playbook for not doing anything in terms of tightening is Japan. And I would make the argument that the Fed hasn't really tightened. Commercial and industrial loans are up 10% year over year. M2 is up 5%. So we're not really there yet. So I think the market became too myopically focused on the Fed's balance sheet reduction and rate raises in the event that this would somehow slow us down. We're a long way from normalization. I think the Fed should continue reducing their balance sheet. And every time the long bond gets below 3%, it's like, I don't know why they're just hitting sell.
Let's talk about this week because it is a big one. 22% of the S&P.
And so that's the one thing I would be watching is the Federal Reserve and the actions they're taking. And what he had just mentioned, which is that they would cut the rates again. And I even have predicted that there's a possibility they'll go negative. And if they go negative on interest rates, there's going to be a lot of a day of reckoning coming. And the inflation will be extraordinary. I mean, eventually this inflation will start to come out. And that's where I see cryptocurrencies finally gaining some tailwind or beginning to pick up, because the dollar will eventually lose value. They can't just keep printing. And as this economy is slowing and they tried tightening, it hasn't worked. So I would highly recommend that you pay attention to what the Federal Reserve is doing. And if you're a real estate investor, I would take advantage if they do go with negative interest rates, and if rates drop, if home loans drop and you're able to get home loans for under 3%, I'm going to be buying. Buy. So let me know what you think about this, and I will talk to you guys soon.